Welcome to the Campervan channel. Today we're continuing to celebrate the 70th anniversary of the VW Transporter, the simple van that's at the heart of every VW campervan on the planet. In the previous video, I've already had a look back at the origins of the Transporter and its first incarnation, the Splitty. Today, we're cranking up our air-cooled engines and spluttering into the 1970s to pay homage to the bay window and then on into the 80s to wonder at the wedge. There's no doubt that the first generation of Transporter, the Splitty, was a hard act to follow. By 1967, VW had sold nearly 2 million of them and, unexpectedly, created a cultural icon for the flower power generation. When the second generation of Transporter was revealed, the basics were familiar. A versatile commercial vehicle with an air-cooled engine at the back, loads of carrying capacity and loads of versions, including vans, buses, combis and pickups. But the styling was very different. The split windscreen had been replaced by a single piece of curved glass, which gives this generation of Transporters its nickname, the bay window. A sliding door became standard to improve access to the load space. Over the T2's lifetime, there were countless technical and safety improvements, tiny detail changes, and engine tweaks. And of course, they were extremely popular with converters, introducing the VW Transporter to an even bigger community of VW campervan fans. For newcomers to the campervan scene like me, bay windows can be divided into two basic groups, early bays and late bays. This is going to get a bit nerdy. The telltale signs of an early bay, built between 1967 and 1971, are the front indicators being low down near the bumper, the rear brake lights being really small, and smooth wraparound bumpers front and back. To identify a late bay built from 1973, you need to look out for the indicators that have moved up to the level of the grille. Tail lights, which are much bigger, taller. And the bumpers now have a groove in them and don't wrap around the corners quite so much. I'm fully aware that that leaves 1971 and 1972 unaccounted for. Well, these are the crossover years when you could get some of the new features, but not all of them. For instance, you might get a new back end, but still have an old front end, just to confuse us. In 1971, the Transporter celebrated its 21st birthday by passing the 3 million production mark. Main production of the T2 ended at VW's Hanover factory in 1979. But slightly modified versions would continue to be built in Brazil until as late as 2013. It's easy to spot a Brazilian. They've got a deeper roof, about 10 centimetres above the gutter line, and there's a good chance that they'll have a radiator grille, because shock horror, the later Brazilians had water-cooled engines. Now, many people thought the replacement for the bay, the T3 Transporter, would finally ditch air-cooled engines altogether. But it didn't, not to begin with at least. What did change was the styling, radically. It was hard-edged, angular, and led many people to nickname it the brick or the wedge. Of course, the purists hated it, but like every generation of Transporter, the T3 found its fan base and continued to improve throughout its production run. I should mention that this third generation of Transporter is known as the T25 in the UK and the Vanagon, a kind of mix of van and station wagon in the USA and Canada. The Transporter was 32 years old when it finally got its water-cooled engine. For its 35th birthday, it had a total revamp. It's claimed that there were over 1,000 changes made to the T3. Now, whether you believe that or not, there were certainly big improvements to the suspension, fuel injection systems, and the introduction of the Syncro, the first ever four-wheel drive Transporter. Like their predecessors, the T3s made fantastic campervans, and the Westfalia versions have a real cult following, particularly in the States. They say life begins at 40. Well, for the Transporter, it was certainly the beginning of a whole new world. Our next video, celebrating 70 years of the Transporter, takes us from the T4 or Euro van right up to the present day, when the future for the Transporter is electric. We're planning over 100 videos on VW campervans, so please subscribe to the channel, that'll really help us along, and if you click on the bell icon, we'll be able to let you know when every new video comes off our assembly line. Thanks for watching.